repeat what you just said. How much is gas in California?
And here in Roseville, California, just above the Capitol, it is $6.99 and 9 cents.
I'm thinking back here. How could a 17-year-old kid with his first car, who's going to school, maybe working a little part-time job, how the hell can he afford it? Even today with higher wages and everything, how the hell can he afford that?
Diesel $7.20, I'm sorry. 20 cents more.
What station? Oh, what gas station? I'm curious. Not Costco, I hope.
No. AM, PM.
Oh, yeah. I know AM, PM. I go there. I get beer at the AM, PM. Those little convenience stores have the best, weirdest beers in the world.
Yeah, it's like a truck stop front. Yeah. They got everything you need for the day.
I love those places where you can get a 5-pound bag of buffalo jerky or something, or reindeer. Did you ever go into a really good truck stop? Going on 70, going due east, or well, these big, huge truck stops.
Yep, we got them on the 405 northern side of the Grapevine. Yeah.
You can take showers there and everything. Did you ever go to the kit? And they got these monstrous gift shops, and they got the beer. Yeah. And I mean, you can get a beaver claw back scratcher. Right? You can get all this weird shit.
And I think a wedding dress.
You can get anything. You can even take a shower. Anything. You can even take showers at these trucks, which I would not do. Oh, my God. Gas here in Colorado, I'm thinking it's, and I'm in a little town in the mountains in Colorado. I am an hour and 20 minutes from Denver proper. Mm-hmm. Gas is $4.29.
Wow.
$4.29. That's still high in my book. What's the
bit? Yeah, go ahead. It's not reasonable. No.
Oh, yeah. That's still high. Here, should we age ourselves right now? And what is the cheapest gas you can ever remember in your life?
Oh,
I bet I can top you because I'm older than you.
It was a Sprout. I think it was about 30 cents, 35 cents for sure.
I remember 29 cents.
Yeah, I think I could barely read. I barely comprehend what I was looking at, but yeah.
29 cents at the KO gas station in Mine Hill, New Jersey. Right near Dover, New Jersey,
right?
29 cents a gallon. I must have been 16 years old, 17 years old.
Yeah. I think right around the time, right after the embargo, it went to 50. We all thought we were going to.
So tell me, how do people afford $7? How's a working family? Mom's working, dad's working, two kids. They're renting an apartment or something. They're trying to make ends meet. Just decent people. Mom has a car, dad has a car. They're both going to jobs. Maybe together they're making $75,000, $85,000, $100,000. I'm trying to be the mean family.
Right.
Okay. Is that close? Would that be under $100,000 a year? Is that normal?
Sure. Oh, sure.
How?
Plenty around 40, sure. 60.
Yeah. How are they surviving?
They can't.
Wow. What is California doing to the nuclear family, the decent, hardworking people, when they charge for utilities like that, when they throw on an extra buck and a half in bullshit taxes?
That's what it is. And no relief in sight.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
That's scary. I mean, I freak out when I spend $111.09. I remember the exact number in Prim, California. It's one of these monster gas stations.
Prim rings a bell.
Prim, yeah. P-R-I-M-M. It's on the highway going through Death Valley as you're leaving Las Vegas or going to Las Vegas. And it's this gigantic gas
station. That's right. Place.
Oh my God, it's Prim, and there's another little town called Jean, another little casino town just before Vegas, these little these little casino towns. Yeah. Have you ever driven that route? Route 50. I think I said 70 early. Route 15, I meant.
15 is what it is.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, let me share my screen with you here for a second, show you a couple. I'm back in Colorado. This was Colorado this week. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Look at that.
How lovely.
Look at that. We had snow this week.
That is a good thing. Yeah. Is that, kind of early, no?
No, it snows. I'm surrounded by the Continental Divide right outside my window here. I'm at 9,200 feet. The mountains go to 11,000 here.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is actually low for Colorado. We have what we call 14ers. Goes up to 14,000 feet.
Yeah.
And they can keep snow until, I've seen it till early July.
Wow.
I'm on there.
Wow.
Yeah, it's great here. In the mornings, it's like, it can be 39 to 43 degrees. And then mm-hmm. it warms up to about 70, 75 degrees. Mm-hmm. Nice day.
Yeah.
And then it's like, it's great. We'll have a few days where it might hit 80 and the bugs come out, the mosquitoes and stuff. And then we'll get a couple 39 degree, 40 degree mornings. Mm-hmm. Kills all the mosquitoes.
Oh yeah, we got a little bit of that.
Oh yeah, yeah. I'm surprised we haven't had a lot more people coming on today.
Yeah, I thought everybody went last weekend.
Did I do one last weekend? I don't remember.
I mean, everybody was out of town doing other stuff.
Oh, I did. Routine. It was Memorial Day weekend.
Yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely. Oh, so what do you think the economy is going to be going? Real estate still healthy?
Yeah.
I mean,
I think the financing of it is tricky. I mean, that's chop, not tricky, just it's choppy. It's changed. It's changing. I can tell, you know, by talking to the local realtors. They have inventory, they have buyers, it's the banks. What else is new?
Yeah. One of my students, I'm going to try to get him on for Monday. Mm-hmm. I've known this kid, he's, what is he now? I think he's 23 years old. I had him once on a couple of years ago. I've been working with this kid since he was 18 years old. He got his real estate license.
Wow.
Started his own coffee business in California.
Yeah.
This kid is his parents thought he was going to college. Instead, he started a coffee truck and drove this coffee truck all around, made money, got his real estate license, started doing a few deals, made some commissions and everything. And then he moved to Oklahoma.
Uh-huh.
Now he's 23 years old. He's looking into buying a $1 million car wash.
Uh-huh.
He has a catering business. And he just did a real estate deal this week and made $60,000 net, 23 years old.
Yeah.
Do I love this? Do I love this kid?
No money working for it. Yeah.
Do I love this kid? And
I'll bet. You know,
I wish that was me when I was that. I was always entrepreneurial, but the kid has such guts and he tries things, all these different things. And he started also, what do you call that when you clean cars meticulously?
Detail business.
He has a detailing business. He learned how to do detailing in California. So he started detailing cars in Oklahoma City. Yeah. He didn't have many California style detailing, you know, like we have.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And now he's got three guys working for him doing detailing.
There you go.
And he needs several more guys. This is the funny. This tells you a lot about our economy and stuff.
Yeah.
He's been doing ads, running ads like crazy to hire people who want to make $20 an hour.
Yeah.
He had 20 people call him up who wanted to come for an interview.
Yeah.
Okay. A group interview. How many? Guess how many people showed up?
Or half. I'm telling you, Claude.
You can't make this. You can't make this shit up, Ben.
I believe you. I'm helping out a friend. She's got this 5-year plumbing drama on a nice home. And so I go on Saturdays, I sort it out for her. It's been 5 years of incompetent repairs and just shenanigans. Anyway, so I'm there. She asked me, do I know a painter? She has these two very fine doors, the main rear door, the front door. Painter shows up. We have to call him. Kind of thing. He shows up, starts futzing with the dog, and the cat, and there's a little bit of an incident in the house. He doesn't have a tape measure. He doesn't have a clipboard. He doesn't have a business card.
What does that tell you?
He's getting top dollar. It tells me that it's definitely a provider's market. Which is what everybody's saying, and I can't get my head around that.
Let me, it's crazy. I'll give you a thing. My, I think I told a story about my accountant.
Yeah.
Okay. My accountant, 80 years old, retired. I've had this guy for, I don't know, 27, 28 years. I have corporate accounts. I have personal account. Yeah. I have a lot of taxes to do. And frankly, a good accountant to me doesn't matter how much they cost because they save me money. That's the way I look at it. So I said,
amen.
Well, yeah, what's that?
Amen to that.
Yeah, absolutely. Amen.
Ask anybody who's been down the dark side of that street. Which
so I go
never.
On, so I go on Yelp.
Yeah.
I like Yelp. I've hired in California, I have a great plumber. You just told a plumber. I found a great plumber on Yelp. The guy returned my phone calls. He texted me. He came at the right time. He fixed it, what he was supposed to do. And he could have charged me a lot more. I expected him to be $200-$300 more than he was. It was under. It was like that, right. You know, that's as good as it gets with a plumber. It was about $200-$300 cheaper than I thought he'd do for the job, a washer dryer thing. Mm-hmm. And I love this. And I found him on Yelp and I said, boy, this is the way you read the reviews, Yelp.com. And so I said, let me do the same thing with an accountant. So I went online and I looked for accountants and I saw a fairly young guy. And I called him up. He called me back. And he sounded real good on the phone. I said, okay, let me send you my previous tax returns. I need to do my quarterly taxes for April. Corporate and personal file, quarterly filings, and I need to make a payment on it. And they make up a simple form and everything. So I send them all the paperwork, we overnight it or what to them. And this is 8-9 weeks before it's due. Mm-hmm. And I have a good conversation. The guy's a good salesman. He sounds competent, very likable. You know how dangerous people are when people are likable. I tend to trust.
If you're saying so, he is. That's just, come on.
So yeah. 2 weeks, 3 weeks go by. I call him. Oh, I'm working on it right now. I'll get it done. I'll get back to you in about 10 days, 2 weeks. Okay. That goes. Make a long story, long story short. I three times at least, I said, have you got it done? Because we need to make our April 15th payment. I don't screw around with the IRS. We make our quarterly payments to the state and the feds on time. I don't need that hassle in my life. And us 2 weeks before April 15th, I call him. Nothing. Don't get anything back to him. And then I said, screw this. He's fired. I said, I'm just gonna make up. I found the form on the IRS from the previous one. And I sent him what I paid him last year. I just sent them the same. As long as you send them money, they leave you alone, even if you don't file the paperwork.
Mm-hmm.
You can get that extension or whatever they call it and everything. And so I called them up and I said, we're done. I can't work with you. Oh, give me one more chance. I'm sorry. I'll make it. No,
you're kidding me.
No, I said, no, man, I can't do business like this.
One more chance.
Yeah.
How about that?
So anyway, I called up my financial advisor, guy. I've known him for long time. He's made us a lot of money. Good guy. And I said, give me an accountant you know and trust. I should have asked for a referral from somebody I know. He gave me a guy, called me back the other day. We hired him on the spot on the phone. We sent him that. He's taking care of everything. I don't care what the guy charges. I just want him to do the damn job. Why is it so hard to hire people today?
In terms of a referral, this guy, this painter, I know him because I've been having coffee with him a couple times. He's one of the locals. We have coffee a couple times a week in the morning. Everybody's like, yeah, he's the painter. He painted that. This is the go-to painter. The guy who shows up with no car. No, what, you know, we're not exactly in the sticks out here. I don't get it.
You're in Sacramento?
I'm in Roseville, which is about 20, 30 minutes outside of it.
Okay.
This is a suburb that is not hurting for money.
There are
the story is,
Go ahead.
Oh, the story is the locals say is that everybody, all of the decent tradespeople are down in the East Bay, San Francisco area, because it's paying so much. I don't know.
Can you imagine a young guy
beyond comprehension what goes on in the labor market?
Can you imagine a young person today out of high school? Maybe they go to one of those, what do you call those utility high schools? What did they call them? Votech schools.
Oh, yeah. Vocational, trades.
Yeah. One of those vocational schools. Young man or woman who wants to become a plumber, an electrician, or a carpenter. Can I say man and women? Is that okay? Is that offensive to you, Ben? I'm sorry. I said men and women. I'm sorry.
I don't even think about it. I get it. We got a young person wants to learn a trade.
I'm going to digress.
That doesn't look so good.
I had to fill out an application with a corporation. I won't say their name or anything.
Yeah.
Just the other day. It was an extensive application. And the woman on the phone, it was really funny. She said, what gender do you, I swear, Claudia, she comes in the room, she'll vouch for me.
You see that now.
What gender do you identify with?
Yeah. And a couple of choices I don't understand. I don't know what those boxes would mean if I checked them.
What gender do you identify with?
My name is Ben. I've been going by Ben forever.
Yeah.
My grandfather's name.
Yeah. Okay? Oh my God. Then she asked, here was the next question. This is a new one. This threw me for a loop. Because we were talking for 10, 15 minutes already, filling a name, address, and all that good stuff. And she said, what is your language of choice to communicate with? I said, ma'am, we've been speaking English for 15 minutes.
She said,
I'm sorry, sir. I'm just reading the questions. I said, ma'am, that is an absurd question. We've been speaking English. And I think by the tonality of my voice, you can tell I'm a man. I hope so. I'm sorry. I'm in the wrong universe, man. I'm in the wrong place.
I know what you mean. I do know what you mean. You wonder what planet? Yeah.
These are the things that really happen in my world, and I take notice of them. Maybe other people, this is just, just passes through. This is just the way. In my universe, I don't understand a
right.
lot of stuff.
Right.
It's too damn stupid. What is the language of your choice? We're in America. We're speaking English. I know a lot of people speak a lot of other languages. I speak a little Spanish and German. I respect other religions, cultures, and things. But we speak English here, and I had a 15-minute conversation in English. Yeah. Why would you have to ask that question?
Yeah.
Do you know what's my relief from all this nonsense in the world?
I don't.
I have to have a valve to release.
Sure.
Other than talking to you today.
Yeah.
I watch Westerns. I love old Westerns.
Yeah.
What is your favorite Western? I'll put you on the spot.
Again, oh boy.
I've been watching Westerns every night. I've been watching a new West, an old Western. I've probably seen 2-3 times.
Yeah. Yeah. It's either going to be John Wayne or Clint Eastwood.
I just saw a great Western. It was called The Big Country, and it's a long Western. It's 2 hours and something long. It's called The Big Country. And wherever they film this, man, this is it looks like Arizona, Utah. It's in the canyons, and I'm the film, and the photography is amazing. And it's called The Big Country. And you can see it. I think it's on Netflix or one of the states. A good Western, man.
Nice.
It's just a good old Western. I saw Clint Eastwood again in Unforgiven.
Sure.
Did you ever see Silverado?
Yeah.
It's a classic. It's a funny, it's a good Western, man.
Here's a good one for you. And I know that your daughter does voice work professionally. When I was a kid, my mother was a business manager for the studios, Motion Picture Studios. So there was a gentleman, he was the second Marlboro man, very successful model.
Really?
And and he transitioned into acting, and everybody thought this is a shoo-in, this guy. And he did Planet of the Apes, the original one.
We talking about Charlton Heston here?
Yeah, there was Charlton Heston, two other astronauts. He was one of the other guys. And what happened was his voice, you know, we didn't have the technology that we do now. His voice did not carry across on audio well. It sounded terrible, in fact. It sounded kind of feminine. And that used to happen back then. There were, like, I had a girlfriend, and it depended on what your medium was. Some looked better in print, some looked better in 35 motion picture, some looked better on video. It's what the technology lent itself to. There were some, of course, who looked fantastic all the way across, but there were some, certain mediums didn't favor them. And that's what happened to him. So he did a couple of spaghetti Westerns, and then his career was over. His voice was, they couldn't make it happen. And he was a strapping cowboy guy. And they couldn't get a voice tone, you know.
You remember the original Marlboro Man commercial? Good looking guy on a horse.
Right.
Cowboy hat. I think he had a mustache.
Yeah.
Did he have a red plaid shirt on
Sure did, red plaid. Yeah.
What did you call those shirts? Those flannel shirts. You know how you dress in Colorado? You got a flannel shirt, jeans, and Sorels, cowboy boots out here.
Yeah,
we're in
Sounds
cowboy.
Good to me. Right?
Have you ever been to Wyoming?
I have not. I've been to Colorado.
Wyoming is an amazing city. It's an hour and a half
from
Colorado, about where I'm in Colorado. It is true. It is a true West state. You go into these little towns in Colorado, and these guys are wearing Stetsons, man.
Real deal.
And they're wearing guns, and some of them wear guns. You can wear guns as long as it's exposed. My son worked in a town, Gillette. I mean, they drive their pickup trucks and they got their dogs. And you're in another world. And I don't know.
I'd love to see that.
Everybody feels really safe, by the way.
You know, I'm sure. What you see is what you get.
When you see grandma in a walker going down the produce aisle, and she's got a Smith & Wesson on the side, you'd see these things. Now, not everybody dresses. Not everybody's like that. Not everybody can. I don't want to disparage. I love Wyoming. I really do. But that's a real Western. That's a real cow. If you ever see their license plate, it's a cowboy on a horse.
That's right. Yeah, I've seen it. Yeah.
You gotta, if you ever take a road trip, you want to take a, you gotta go to these other states, this other America, I call it, Montana. Mm-hmm. Montana's, mm-hmm. and these states are beautiful. Oh my God. Mm-hmm. They have mountains.
So everybody says.
Oh yeah. You go to Montana, Utah.
New Mexico.
I love New Mexico. I almost moved to, you know my New Mexico story, right?
No, I don't think so.
Claudia and I were looking for a second home, a country home. Yeah. So we love New Mexico. We get New Mexico magazine. We go to the Balloon Fest in Albuquerque every year, you know, like 100 balloons in the sky. It's amazing. And they do it. So we found this little town near Alamogordo. And that's the little clue to this story. And this town south of Alamogordo, and not far from Texas, called Ruidoso, which I believe in Spanish means river.
Yeah.
You ever go to a little town and you fall in love with it? It's a little town with the little cute gift shops and stores.
Sure.
They have a ski area nearby because it's a little bit of it's got
all
a little
the,
bit
all
of
the artisan stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, it's got a little elevation. It has an Indian casino. It has a library, has a little airport, and the little river goes through it. And they got all these little gift shops in the, it's the cutest town. And we're looking at land there and 5-acre lots.
Joseph and Helen have joined us.
Joseph and Helen, hi kids.
Yeah, hi, it's
Just Joseph. Okay.
I'm talking about a town I found in New Mexico called Ruidoso, and a beautiful little cute town, 5-acre lots,
right?
Beautiful wooded land, $25,000.
Wow.
Which even 20 years ago was a bargain.
Yeah.
Okay. They wanted to develop and build up this town, and they weren't that far. I think they were a couple hours from El Paso, Texas. And so beautiful, and you know, really upscale, very nice. And everything. Oh. And so we're looking at the land and the deer, a couple deer hop across the land like the real estate agent timed it or something. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. And everything. And I loved it. Claudia loved it, but I couldn't get Claudia to go ahead with me on it.
Yeah.
For one little reason. And I gave you the clue when I said Alamogordo, which is the next town down the street.
Yeah.
Did that ring a bell? Is that anything trigger?
Yeah.
Historic?
The Alamo.
No, Alamo was in Texas.
Right.
This is New Mexico still.
I don't know.
I have no idea.
It was Alamogordo is 60 miles from a place called Trinity Point. Another clue.
Zero here.
First atom bomb was dropped there.
Well, she's got a valid argument.
Oh yeah. Well, we went to the Chamber of Commerce. We talked with one woman. Nobody wants to talk about this nuclear bomb that was dropped in the United States on purpose.
Yeah.
During World War II.
Yeah.
And so we kept asking people. We went in the chamber. And we went to this one woman working behind the desk, and she kind of looked both ways, and she said, "You know, my uncle lost all his teeth and hair a couple years after they dropped that bomb."
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a town in California. I won't say which one but there's a town in California and in Southern California, and forever they couldn't give it away, and it was dirt cheap and la, la, la. And that had to do with the fact that there was a nuclear mishap that was a commercial thing, not the government. A commercial contractor had a mishap. So there were all of these disclosure pieces in place. And it was for 50 years. And once all that passed, all of a sudden, very quietly, the value started to soar. This was just a couple years ago. And it was really interesting the way that the value just took off, and it was unspoken. It was, I'm not real clear on it, but I watched it happen. And all of the locals, I knew a woman who's, you know, had grown up there all her life. Three sisters. Her father had one of, you know, the first big businesses out there. It was pretty much common knowledge.
Pretty scary. It's like, what was that other place where they had the accident? 3 Mile Island.
Porter Ranch. Oh no,
Remember 3 Mile Island?
Sure.
Remember, oh, Chernobyl.
The movie. Yeah, Chernobyl. Which, yeah, and you don't know. There's, well, you know, it's from real estate. We have the what they call the brown dirt issues. When, like gas stations and what have you, you can't, they become so toxic that only certain businesses can be placed there. You can't just come and do whatever you want. It's prohibitive to secure all that, to dig out the toxicity and secure the toxicity and what have you.
Wow.
They just don't, and they don't want the liability. You know what I mean? Let it remain some toxic business.
How many, I don't even believe in San Diego, there are houses built close to these huge electrical towers. You know, the, and I don't believe people buy those houses. I hope nobody here has a house near an electrical thing. I, this is how I get into trouble. But I wouldn't buy a house like that, would you?
I heard somewhere that it's like 400 feet is good enough to be out.
I want 800 feet. I want 8,000 feet. I don't want to be near something.
No, I'm with you. I just what I heard.
Yeah.
And the trouble, give me a number.
And the trouble is, who gave you that 400 feet statistic? Some guy in some guy in a government office?
Yeah.
I don't remember, but possible. Very possible.
Oh my gosh.
Not a chance. I have a cousin-in-law who works for a utility, big California utility company, and his job is, he's an educated guy. He goes out into the, he tracks missing utilities and lines and gathers data on stuff that resources they've lost track of. His job is to go out and find the stuff they've lost.
Oh my God.
And you know, yeah. Why? It's crazy. It's, he's got two huge screens on his desk at the house. And then, you know, yeah. Or I'll give you a clue. It's Northern California.
Okay.
Yeah.
San Francisco.
Yeah. Just. Is
it? Where else? Did you, do you guys ever watch South Park? It's on HBO.
Yeah.
South Park has one of their episodes this year. I think it was number 3 or 4. Dealt with real estate, deals with real estate this year.
Uh-huh.
And there's a South Park is this little Colorado country town. Okay. Like where the town I'm in.
Right.
Okay. Just this little, these little town, it's a little town outside of Denver. And all of a sudden South Park wants to, they know New Yorkers want to leave New York and come to these little towns in the Midwest, in the West and everything. All of a sudden the town goes, they're selling their little $80,000 homes for $5 million, you know? and all the New Yorkers are worried about is where they can get their Frappuccino or Wi-Fi or sparkling bubble, imported bubble water here.
Yeah. Car service.
It's brilliant. It's the funniest thing ever. Yeah. Oh, they do great stuff. Joseph, you're taking your little walk today, huh?
Yes, I am. Yes.
How many miles?
Good idea.
So I am not counting miles. Usually I am walking from hour to hour and a half.
Good boy.
Good.
That's at least that's at least two and a half to 4 miles, depending on your pace.
Yeah, so I'm not in a hurry, you know. So
you don't have to be in a hurry.
Yeah, I'm walking, I'm listening to you, to somebody else. So.
Yeah. Walking is good. Moving every day is good.
For sure.
Yeah. Yeah. Cannot convince Helen to do it. So
yeah.
So no chances. We've been on Myrtle Beach recently. I told her, let's go walk along the ocean. And she told me, you know what? I'm going to be sitting on the balcony. It's fresh air, you know, shadow. So it's good enough for me.
Did everybody have a good week? How was your week? Business-wise, let's talk business for a minute.
Okay.
How was your week business-wise?
So we are getting into the contract today. At least we signed the contract for one small house in the town, which nobody knows where is it, but it's between Charlotte and Myrtle Beach, right in the middle. This is going to be our fourth house over there.
Fantastic.
So my goal is to rename this town in our name. So we'll be continuing doing this.
There we go. You're taking over your own little town. Who are those Hollywood people who bought a town? Was Roseanne Barr and Arnold, what's his name? Didn't they buy a town?
Oh, yeah, Arnold.
Didn't they try Tom to buy Arnold. A town or something like yeah. that? Or am I thinking of someone else? Demi Moore and the guy from all those action movies. Help me out, Ben.
Willis?
Bruce Willis. That's it. That's it.
Yeah. Every now and then they'll do that.
Oh.
They buy it, you know, I think it was 10 million.
Amazing. I did a deal.
One night.
Did you guys read my post in the Skype today? I did a deal this week, but I'm a little embarrassed. It took me three meetings to close this guy. I'm serious. Three meetings. Usually one, the first one leading to a close second one follow-up. Very rare three. Rare three. I could not close this. I could not get instinctually, I didn't press as hard as I usually do.
Okay.
I usually get right to the point. I'm very direct with very straightforward people.
Yeah, we've seen you do it.
And I knew if I pushed too hard, too fast with this person, I had to draw them in emotionally more. And it took to the third time. Usually by the third time, it doesn't happen.
Usually.
But I did close, and it was a nice contract. But I was a little surprised that it worked. I thought, boy, this isn't going to happen. We're going to the third meeting on this thing.
The person is just difficult or touch and go, or did you feel like you had it targeted?
You know, I had a feeling time. it was a nice person, and I instinctually just, you ever go by your gut, by your instincts?
Yeah.
I had the feeling that I had to win him over more and more and more.
All right.
On it. Just, it was an instinctual thing. Usually I can make it so emotional by the first phone call or the first leading into the second, I can close some or get done. I don't close everybody.
Oh, interesting. All right.
But on this one, I thought, I never do this. I thought I need, it's going to take one more meeting with this guy.
Yeah.
And
you were right.
And I was right.
So,
I was like, And if it didn't happen, I would have beat myself up. So you didn't follow your own rules.
For sure. For sure. Yeah.
I didn't follow my own rules.
What was I thinking? What did I?
There's so much of real estate or any business is about making that connection with that person who's the decision maker. You don't have to
absolutely.
They feel they see the value. I think it's the perception of value about you, your personality, or the product or service you're selling.
Yeah. I think we develop our sense of that. I'm certain of it. From how many times it took me years to get completely calm to where it's almost natural. We're going, is there anybody else involved?
Yeah.
In this decision.
Yeah.
Before we go.
I got two invitations. One to speak in October in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, public speaking, all expenses paid. I love that. Uh-huh. And I love Idaho. That's another Western state. By the way. Have you ever been to Idaho?
No, I don't.
Cowboy state. I'll tell you. They're still wearing those MAGA hats out there.
We got a few of them around here.
Did you ever, there was a Larry David, Curb Your Enthusiasm. Larry David from Seinfeld.
Yeah.
Great show.
And he doesn't want people to bother him. He doesn't want people to sit next to him in the restaurant on the counter and everything. So, and he starts wearing a MAGA hat all over. Did you ever see this one?
I didn't see that.
No, it's new one. Yeah. So we did not see. We used to love older seasons.
Yeah.
It was hysterical, and and if you're in California, you don't see too many of those red hats.
We have them up here. We still have many pickup trucks sporting the flag.
Okay.
No.
Yep. We.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Joe.
I'm sorry. Yeah, we were driving to Estonia, which is outside of Charlotte, to visit friends, and it was on a post over there. Company, let's go, Brandon will mow your lawn.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was interesting. Company name. It's unbelievable.
Wow.
I never go political, but I like to note all the things that are going on here. Here in Colorado, sure, they had pickup trucks with the when Trump won the last election with the big flag flying, the big blue Trump flag and everything. It was kind of very demonstrative.
Yes. We have those here.
California is very interesting. Politically, California is very democratic, very left-leaning. Yet there are very many pockets in California that are very right-wing, that are very conservative. It's, I'm in San Diego. I live in San Diego. It's a military town.
Sure.
Guess what we know about military people who put themselves in harm's way and serve their country?
They're patriots.
They're patriots. They're pretty conservative. They're pretty conservative people.
Yeah.
They're pretty conservative on it. So it's kind of interesting. California is it's a very confusing place. When I go back, I've been in Colorado or North Carolina for 4, 5, 6 months, and then I go back to California. It's like a shock to me sometimes. I like North Carolina.
South Carolina better.
Oh yeah, South Carolina is even. Oh yeah, it's really funny when you go to these different states. I know we're a country of 50 states and we're supposed to be a homogenous society, but different states have such different political climates that it's astounding.
That's for sure.
Oh yeah.
Nevada was that way when I was younger. Forever, it was. They didn't have a lot of rules, but the few that they had, there was no margin, zero. You crossed the line, you paid for it all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, very little crime in Las Vegas, as you know.
There was,
of course, mafia, for years mafia and years. Doesn't sleep, yeah.
Where was, oh God, someone told me, oh, someone, I met someone this week who lives, I can't remember the name. It's a Colorado town that has a casino. We don't have, and it's not a Native American casino. It's an old casino going back to the old silver mining days. It's this little town, not many people. They have the casino. It's a little off the beaten path, but it's not bad.
Yeah.
And they have no crime, and they have one of the best school systems in Colorado.
Yeah,
I could live in a casino town. I think I could live in a casino town like that.
Sure.
You're safe. You've got all full city services. Got
right. Good schools. Decent tax base. Yeah. And longstanding values.
Do you think people are going to continue to move to small town America? The New Yorkers, the LA, San Francisco, the people. You think they're going to continue to move to these small towns in South Carolina and in?
I believe so.
I think so as well.
Yeah, I believe so. You know, so I don't remember if we told you when we were selling our house in this town of Bishopville, which is in the middle between Charlotte and Myrtle Beach. It's absolutely in the middle of nowhere, absolutely. And we put ad on Facebook, and the town, I believe, population about 1,000, maybe 1,500 people. And so we put ad on Facebook, us, and Facebook asked us if we would like to broad the area outside of Bishopville. We told no, and we got for 3 days, we got 13,000 something hits on our ad.
Wow. Wow.
It's for in the small town, which you can see only if you are looking for exactly this place.
Joseph, I have to ask you, how much was that ad? What they charge you?
Ad itself, ad was free.
For free. 13,000 hits for free.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Can't beat social media. Can't beat social media marketing, can you?
Yeah, so they asked if we would like to broad it for, I believe, for 40 or 50 miles radius more for $6 per week.
Yeah.
Additional.
Okay.
As long as it works.
Yeah, it doesn't mean that we got so many calls, but it was hit because they are sending you statistic how many hits it was, and I was completely surprised.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, when we are asking someone, so what do you think, how many hits it was? They said, oh, if you ask, so maybe 100. You know, so something like that.
Gentlemen, I just got the dinner bell. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
And it's either stay here with you guys and have this wonderful conversation, or have a hot slice of pizza for dinner. Guess who won?
Yeah. I don't know. I would choose to stay with us, but it's your choice.
I would too. Yeah.
Well, I'll make you an offer, Ben. I'll leave this on, and Ben, you can be moderator for Beer with Claude.
Okay. Have a nice dinner. Say hello to Claude.
You guys are great. Thank you so much, Ben. Always a privilege. Thank you, guys. Have a good, safe weekend. Okay.
Yeah. Take care.
You too. Thank you. Bye bye.
Take care.
Bye bye.